Okay, so. Try to work on these, shouldn't take you long. Remember, everything is just a building block, really, in math. Take skills to build on top of other skills, develop new skills. Okay, so try these out. It's gonna help you throughout the lesson today. Try working on the back of that. How you doing today? Confused, Trevor. You okay?
Yeah. Do we add the two x's on three, or do we like do 5 minus 10?
Yeah, what do you mean? Do you combine like terms?
Do we combine or do we?
Unless you take that.
I think we minus. We do like 5x minus 10.
Okay, and what'd you get?
I got -5 there. But I don't think that's right. It's gonna be 15x.
Would it be 15x?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
-5 minus 10x. Is it?
Yeah.
I'm asking you.
Yeah.
If you had to tell me whether or not
yeah.
My life was on the line for 5 minus 10x, what would you say? My life is on the line.
-5x.
-5x. There you go. I survived. You didn't let me die. Good? Y'all good?
Yeah.
ready to
proceed?
Yeah.
Let's start with number two. I don't want to start with number one. Let's start with two. Lisa, what I'm going to do with this four outside of Princeton? Yep, we're going to distribute. We get 4y minus what? Okay. That's 4 times 2. Mm-hmm. All right. Now what? Add 8 on both sides. And then we get 4y equals 28. Now what? Divided by 4 on both sides, and what's 28 divided by 4? 7. Good job. Multiplication coming in handy. Getting it. There you go. Alright, Trevor, I want you to let's attack number 3 here. Mm-hmm. Shall we? let's see what you got.
5x minus 7x is negative 5x.
So I got negative 5x. What am I going to do with the 8?
Bring it down.
Alright, what about 33?
Bring it down.
Bring it down. Okay.
Minus 8 on both sides.
Minus 8. And then what do I get?
Then bring down the negative 5x.
What happens here?
Oh, you mark that up.
Mark it out? Okay. So bring down the negative 5x, and then what's 33 minus 8?
25.
Is that positive or negative?
Positive.
Okay. Now what?
8 divided by 5 on both sides.
Negative 5 on both sides.
And then you get negative 5.
Okay, yeah, I did pretty good with this. Alright, good job. Good job. Now, I'll go ahead and just take care of this one. Save some time here. We're going to subtract 8 on both sides. 2x equals what? 12.
Yeah.
All right. Then I get divide by 2. Then I get x equals 6. Any questions on those? Y'all did a good job.
Yeah.
It went pretty smooth, didn't it?
Yeah.
Good. Bless you.
Hey, keep that.
Remember, multiplication quiz is gonna be Thursday this week. It's gonna be Thursday, okay? So be prepared for that. Oh. All right, that's good. So, looking at what we're going to be going over today, my first peer, they wanted me to work it out on the board, which I don't have an issue doing it, but we need to get the beginning part of it down first. Just the notes, all right? So, substitution method. Substitution method, in the grand scheme of things, it's exactly what it is. We're gonna take, y'all need the light on that? Like, this right here? All right. So in the grand scheme of things, it's exactly what it is. We're gonna take whatever we got, substitute it into an equation. Alright, I'm gonna give you a rundown. This probably gonna sound completely out of whack here, but anyway. Substitute an equation into another equation to find a variable, then take that variable and we're gonna substitute it back into the original equation to find the other variable. Does it make sense? No. Okay, so I'm gonna talk about it and I'm gonna show you. Alright. I didn't think it would, but like I said, I was just trying to give you a rundown or a grand scheme of what is about to take place. So, the definition of a substitution method is that it is a method of solving systems of equations by substituting equations within one another. Kind of lengthy, kind of one of those things where it's a lot of words, but it's really, like I say, math is all about steps. All right, the steps to everything. So once you like riding a bike, all right, you never forget the steps of how to ride a bike, right? Like I don't care how long you've been off a bike, you know, you might have a fear of getting on and being able to go at the speed that you used to go might be a little different, but the steps of riding a bike is get on, grab the handlebars, and pedal. And you steer, pedal, steer, pedal, steer. Got my brake here. Those are the steps, right?
Yeah.
Yep. So, same thing for math. I mean, it's just gonna be steps. Step by step, and build on those steps, okay? So, for example, it says here, step one, two, and three. Step one says, solve one equation for X or Y. Step two, substitute this expression into the other equation and solve for the variable. Step three, same thing, is substitute your answer into the revised equation from step one and solve for the other variable. So, like I mentioned when this started, we're gonna take a few, all right, try to pick up on it, ready? We take one equation, plug it into another equation. Make sense so far?
Yeah.
All right, solve for whatever variable is in that equation. So if I plug it in for Y, more likely I'm solving for X. So I take Y, plug it in for Y, solve for X. So if I'm solving for X, I should get an answer for X. Once I get that answer for X, I take that answer and plug it back into one of the original equations. So take Y, plug it in for Y, solve for X. Take X, plug it in for X, solve for Y.
Yeah, that's a little better, man.
All right, is it registered? When I first said it, I was just like, take first equation, solve for it, plug it in. Yeah, I said it kind of quick the first time. But, like it says here, solve one equation for X or Y. Then, substitute this expression. The expression just means equation. Substitute this equation into the other equation and solve for the variable. So if I take x, plug it in for x, I'm going to be solving for y. If I take y, plug it in for y, I'm going to be solving for x. Then substitute your answer into the revised equation from step one. So revise in this instance is mean substitute your answer into the original equation from step one and solve for the other variable. That's essentially what it's saying. So the main thing here I want to tell you is don't get confused with the letters, with the variables. Don't let that throw you off. If it's x, it says x equals, plug it in for x, and then just solve it. Just like we solve these equations for the bell ringer, solve it. So let's look at number one. Number one says y equals 4x minus 1. It also says y equals 2x minus 5. So really we could take either equation and plug it in for y if we wanted to. Alright? So I'm just going to take the top one and plug it in for the bottom. Now, before I even get started, it can look overwhelming because you're solving for two variables and it takes multiple steps. But it can be done, you just gotta be patient and don't get overwhelmed. All right, so I'm gonna take this equation here and plug it into this y right here. So essentially I'm gonna have 4x minus 1 equals 2x minus 5. Now I'm going to start moving stuff around. So I'm going to solve for x. Remember, I want to get x to the left by itself. So I'm going to add one. And then these cancel. Negative 1 plus 1 cancel. Bring down to 4x equals 2x minus 4. If I was asking you right here, you probably would tell me what? What would you want me to do next? Excuse me.
Add the two x's together.
Add the two?
Yeah.
Subtract 2x. Because it's already positive 2x. So I need to subtract. Get negative 4 equals 2x equals negative 4. Right? Now I just divide both sides by 2 to get the x by itself, and I get x equals negative 2. All right, here's the part that you need to make sure you can grasp here. I'm gonna take negative 2 and plug it in for x into either one of these equations, all right? I'm gonna show you why it doesn't matter which one you plug it into. Okay, so let's just plug it into the top. So I got y equals 4, take the negative 2, plug it in for x, minus 1. What's 4 times negative 2?
Negative 2.
4 times negative 2?
Negative 8.
Negative 8. Negative 8 minus 1.
That's what would be.
Minus 1.
No.
Negative 8 minus 1.
Would be 7.
Would it?
Yeah.
Negative 8. So if you got negative $8 in your bank account and somebody take out another dollar, how much money, what's your bank account balance right now?
Probably negative 9.
Negative 9.
Yeah.
Yep. So this would be your answer. Negative 2, negative 9. Now, I'm gonna go over here on the side and show you that when we got negative 2 right here, you could have plugged it into the bottom one as well. So y equals 2, negative 2, minus 5. What's 2 times negative 2?
Negative 4.
Negative 4 minus 5. What's negative 4 minus 5?
Negative 9.
So, as you see, either way you go, you plug it into either equation, it come out with negative 9. With either one, as long as you plug it into the original equation. All right, let's look at number 2. Y'all want me to do number 2 or number 3? I do number 3. How about number 3?
Okay.
Number 3 looks a little bit more like your example that you're going to do. So y equals x plus 9, okay? Y equals x plus 9. I'm simply going to take what y equals and plug it in for y. So it should be 3x plus 8 parentheses x plus 9 equals negative 5, right? I took what y equals, plugged it in for y in the second equation, and now I solve it. Get 3x plus 8x plus 72, negative 5. What's 3x plus 8x?
12.
11x. It's all right. It's a lot going on in your brain right now with this substitution.
Yeah.
I see them wheels up there spinning. Hey,
practice makes perfect.
The more you practice it, the easier it becomes. Right down to 72 equals negative 5 minus 72 minus 72. So we did the 11s before the ACT that we took last week, right? So what's negative 77 divided by 11? Huh?
Negative 7.
You got it. So we found our x, right? Now what am I gonna do? Say it one more time. I mean, you can do 1 parentheses negative 7. Is that what you said?
Or you just put
the negative 7 in? Yeah. You just plug in a negative 7. I mean, even if you did put the 1 there, I mean, if you did 1 parentheses negative 7, you'd still get negative 7 plus 9. It'd just be a waste of a step. So you can simply, you can say y equals negative 7 plus 9. And then what's negative 7 plus 9? 5. I had negative $7 in my bank account and I added $9 to it, how much money I got in there now?
Two.
You was trying to multiply. Two. So my answer would be -7, 2. All right, you guys try 4. The steps we took from the previous problems. Don't let the variables confuse you. So you got x equals, so that you would plug this into. Now, this says x equals. What you did was you plugged this in for y. So can we plug it in for y if it doesn't say y equals?
Mm-hmm.
So plug it in where x equals.
question?
Quick. Close to 10:10.
What time is it?
1:48. Hey, this one up here should be unlocked. You stuck? They're on the same side, you will get 8y minus 6y. That's 8 minus 6. Size, it's like combining like terms. Just go combine. Negative 2 divided by 2.
Is it supposed to
be? So the division is the opposite of multiplication. So what can I multiply to get negative 2? So negative 2 divided by 2 means 2 divided by 2. So what number would I multiply by 2 to give me 2? Let's make sure it's negative. Did you get for X? last part to the door. Negative 4 plus 7. What'd you get? Negative 3? That's correct. Alright, I'm gonna cut this agent slip down just one. Since we're running short on time. Flip to the back side of this. Just on the back right. One problem. This should be simple. Should be simple. Real quick. What?
That's just satisfying.
Huh?
That's satisfying.
That's what?
Satisfying.
It's satisfying. This is the paper rip like that.
Yeah.
Alright. Huh? I'm gonna tell you right now. This one right here. Y equals 2x, and then 5x minus y equals 9. I had to cut it a little bit shorter today. He had 3, but running out of time.